Hey guys, this is Ulrich from Nostalgic Mathematics. Today we will try to solve this JEE Advanced 2019 problem. We are given this integral I and like to compute 27i squared. In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve this problem combining two simple tricks. If you are new here, do not forget to subscribe. So we would like to compute I. The first issue we have comes from this term, 1 plus e to sine x. So I'd like to get rid of this term. But generally speaking, we can get rid of 1 over 1 plus e to fx when f is an odd function. So it comes from this. When focused on this sum, we know that f to negative x is negative fx. Now focusing on this right term, what we're going to do, we just multiply both numerator and denominator by e to fx. And we have this. And the sum e equals to 1. So the way to get rid of this term, as we said, is to perform this substitution, x equals minus t, to have another expression from I. And then we sum both expressions to get rid of this term. We show you how to do in this case. So this substitution is going to give us this, because dx is minus dt. And here we have e to negative sine t. That's what we have. And we know that t is a dummy variable, so we can call t x, and then I equals this. Next, we want to sum this expression of I and this other expression of I. But notice that this sum equals 1, because sine x is an odd function. So when we're going to sum this I and that other I, we're going to have 1 over 2 minus cosine 2x multiplied by this sum, which is 1. So this expression of 2i is correct. And therefore, we did use that I equals this, which is more easy to handle. So we will write I as follow. Now we'd like to have cosine of x in the denominator. So to do so, we just use this duplication formula and I rewrite as follow. That's where we come to our second trick. Because generally speaking, we know how to compute the antiderivative of 1 over a plus b cosine square of x. The key comes from this relationship, because 1 over cosine square of x equals 1 plus tangent square of x. So we write I as follow, dividing both numerator and denominator by cosine square of x. Next, we replace 1 over cosine square of x by this expression. And again, at the denominator, we're going to have this sum. But we know that this is d of tangent x. Next, we use some multiplicative constants to adjust the expression here. And we set the substitution u equals tangent of x to have this. Now to compute this antiderivative, we have two cases. If a plus b over a is positive, we know that this polynomial has no real solution. So we use arctangent function. But if a plus b over a is negative, we know that a plus b over a rewrite as negative k squared. So that this polynomial have two real roots, k and negative k. So we know that we can use the partial fraction technique to compute this integral. Actually, we're going to have the logarithm function in the antiderivative. But in our case, we know that a equals 3 and b equals minus 2. So applying this, I is this integral, because tangent of pi over 4 is 1. And here is going to be minus 1. This function is even function. So I rewrite as 2 over 3 times pi this integral. And we know the antiderivative of this, using the arctangent function, and I just rewrite as follow, because arctangent of square root of 3 is just pi over 3. So the pi here just simplifies and I equals this. So we square this. So I square is going to be 4 over 27, and 27 I square is 4, and this is the answer. Thank you for your attention. Again, do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and post your comments. Bye.